is Jack Johnson, and this one's called Bubbly Toes, or Bubble Toes. And it's a great song. I'm going to teach it to you today. Isn't that great? All right, so there's a few parts of this song. Basically, it has the same kind of chords patterns the whole way through, which is basically G, C, and going up to D. Now, there is this little bit at the beginning as well. It's going to require you stretching your hands to an unimaginable width. Oh my god, yeah. But it's still pretty good. It sounds amazing. It's got that really nice blues kind of... So that's really good. I'm going to teach that for you as well. And there's a little bit at the beginning, which is like that. And it's not too hard. Don't worry about it. If you're freaking out right now, don't worry about it. Alright, so the first bit I'm going to start teaching to you is basically kind of like bar chords, but not really. It's not even really like power chords, because you only use two fingers, your index and this one. So those are the only two that you're going to need for the beginning here. And how it's going to work is you're basically going to put your index finger on the fifth fret of the fifth string over here. And you're going to put your ring finger on the seventh fret of the fourth string. Like so. And you're just going to tap both of those at the same time, one downward, like this. And what you're going to do there is just take exactly the same formation, just move it up one string. Up. Like that. See? So. And instead of this one, you're just going to move it up here, so your index is going to be on the 5th fret of the 6th string, and your ring finger is just going to be on the 7th fret of the 5th string. Right, like that. So, pretty simple, just move it up, and then take exactly the same one once again. This time, move it up the fretboard 2 frets, but just have the exact same one. So, basically, now your index is going to be on the 7th fret over here, and your ring finger is just going to be on the 9th fret of the 4th string, like this. And after that, the next one in line is basically really simply just put those two formation fingers up one on the string and just one fret down the fretboard. So essentially, you're going to have your ring finger on the 10th fret of the 5th string, and your index finger on the it's going to be the 8th fret of the 6th string, like that. Okay, so now you've got to kind of know these different little chords, not really, just little half chords kind of. What is pretty important now is knowing how to change between them. So it goes quite fast. It goes, it's as simple as something that nobody knows. See that? So you basically have to just strum once, and then really quickly, so it's down, 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 and then you're going to take this one and apply it to this one, so basically the same one, just 2 frets down, 1 string down, and then the same thing, down, down, to this chord over here, which is basically this chord, but just up one of the strings, and then down one fretboard over here. And so just one more time, really slow. I'm just going to show you that. So it's down and down, down. And then you do it twice. And then you go into that really, really nice blues riff, which basically starts over here, your index finger on the 3rd fret of the 6th string, and your ring finger is going to be over here on the 5th fret of the 5th string. And your pinky is going to have to be doing the work here. He's the middleman, and he's going to have to stretch out over here to the, oh, that's the 7th fret on the 5th string. So you're going to just tap that once, that formation right there, and then you're going to put your little finger on the 7th over here, 7th fret of the 5th string, and here's the big one, one more, down over here, and so as you can see that's quite a stretch, But that's why we have really long fingers. Alright, and basically one more. So your finger now, your little finger is going to be on the 8th fret. And the same, your index is just going to be on that 3rd fret on the 6th string. And then you put it back one, so you go back to the 2nd position. And go back. So essentially it goes like this. That's the whole blues bit. After that, it goes back into the same one. So I'm going to show you how those kind of go together really well, just a bit slowly. So start with this one. Down, down, down. As you can see, the strung pattern is the same. So just down, down, down. That twice, and that's basically the intro of the song. It's really nice, really, really creative how he did that with the guitar. And after the 2nd time you sing it, so her feet are all covered with tar balls and scars. You sing that first part, so that's kind of like the first part of the intro, and then like after the 2nd part, which is but all I wanted was some. You basically go from this position. And you come back to the G chord. Now, the G chord, for the purpose of this lesson, we can do it two ways. We can do it the open, but the way Jack Johnson plays it is basically with one voice. Because you can really kind of, you know, block it out, and you can highlight the notes as well. And I think that's a really nice way of learning it, and I think everybody should learn it that way. So I'm going to teach the bar chords first. And then at the end, I can teach the open chords as well. Okay, so the bar chord, very simple G bar chord. You put your index and try to block out these strings over here. So that's on the 3rd fret. And then you get your ring finger and you put it over here on the 5th fret of the 5th string. And you put your little finger, you put it on the 5th fret of the 4th string. And then with your middle finger, you're just going to put that on the 4th fret of the 3rd string over here. And it should sound like this. Alright. And then we go into the C. Now the C is the same. You just keep the finger there and then you just move down because you don't want to hit this bass note anymore. You want to hit the 3rd fret of the 5th string, so the C bass note. And with these fingers, you're going to arrange them like so. You're going to put your middle finger on the 5th fret here of the 4th string. And your ring finger, you're just going to put that on the 5th fret of the 3rd string. And your little finger, you're just going to put that on the 5th fret of the 2nd string. And it should sound altogether like this. Alright, if you have difficulty in the beginning doing bar chords, remember that you can kind of just push down with your thumb, and that'll give you more power to do the bar chord, because it'll really get your fingers down on there. And I know it's a bit tough in the beginning, but it goes well after a while, don't worry. So after the C, you're going to have to go into the D major chord. So it's exactly the same as the C major. Just up 2 frets. Okay? So, you can see why that's pretty easy to just go from here. Slide up with exactly the same formation of fingers, everything. And so that's just basically going to be the index finger on the 5th fret, and then the middle finger that's going to be on the 7th fret of the 4th string, and then the ring finger on the 7th fret of the 3rd string, and the little finger on the 7th fret of the 2nd string, and it should sound like this. And that's the D major. Okay, so the really special thing about Jack Johnson is how he uses rhythm to complement his songs a lot. He he's almost kind of like a percussionist. When he plays guitar, he has the beat with him at the same time, and that creates really, really cool groove. So I'm just going to teach you a little simpler way, I think, of doing it. It's kind of like the song, except I think he probably has a couple more, goes a bit faster and stuff like that. But that'll come naturally with the more comfortable you are at strumming and at rhythm. So the really kind of simple way to do it is just by starting on the G, and it's just down, down, up, 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 down. So that's down, down, up, 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 down, in that kind of speed. Down, down, up, 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 down. So down, down, up, 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 down. You can notice as well that I kind of block the chords sometimes by just lifting my bar chord up from the frets, and that creates this kind of cut, kind of sound as well. So it's down, down, up, and then you unlock, down, down, up, and release kind of the fingers and just block the sound coming from the strings, and then up, 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 down. So it's a bit tricky, but if you can do it, it sounds great. So I'm gonna do it once more, just really slowly. So down, down, up. You can see how I just go up, and then you release up, up, down. So after every kind of up stroke, you just release your fingers from the fret and block it like this, essentially. And that creates that percussion that Jack Johnson's really good at. And so that's how you're going to play the first chord, the G chord. And after that, you're going to go to the D chord. And what he does here is he does the same strumming pattern, but he, on the second up, it just lifts to that D chord. So it's going to go a bit like this. Like the first one. Down, 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 up, 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 up. That's like the G. Down, down, up, 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 down. Except on this one, you're going to go down, down, up. And then on the second up, you're just going to up, 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 down. So that's down, down, up. Even more slower, just so that you can understand fully, it's just down, down, up, up. So when you go back up, you just slide across to the D major from the C. Again, it's the exact same position. All you need to do is just up, up, down. With the same kind of percussion, with just relieving your fingers off the fret so you can't really hear it continue the notes. Okay, so I'm just going to do it one more time, really slowly, just so you can get the hang of it. It is a bit hard, but practice on. So that's down, down, up, 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 down. Down, down, up, 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 down. Down, down, up, 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 down. Down, down, up, 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 down. And that's basically it throughout the whole song. Sometimes he mutes it a bit, and he's a really creative guy with rhythm, and so you kind of have to listen to the song a lot, see what the lyrics are kind of meaning, and that way you can play it a bit harder, or you can play it a bit smoother. So there's another little part of the song, and it's a really sweet riff, and it goes a bit like this. And then it goes back to the G and the strumming pattern. So I'm going to teach it to you right now. It's a bit tricky, but you could just use downstrokes on the pick if you're having a hard time. And you get used to it. The important part is kind of you want to strum at the same time that you press down. And this is done really easily. I'll show you how in a bit. So first of all, we're going to start by just playing that first bit. Okay? And that works out by just putting your middle finger on the third fret of the sixth string, doing that twice. And then putting your index finger on the second fret over here of the fifth string. And then adding your middle finger on the third fret of the fifth string. And then just touching it with your little finger, or even with your ring finger if you want. Just that fifth fret over here on the fifth string. And then you go back to the third fret on the sixth string. So that's and that's the little riff. And then after that, basically he does this thing where he kind of like strums at the same time as playing. So you can either do it with downstrokes like this, but it's a bit hard. I prefer generally just doing it like I'm strumming away anyway. But for beginners, I think it's probably best to learn it with downstrokes. So we're gonna put our middle finger, our ring finger over here on the 7th fret. And we're gonna press that twice. And then go up to the 9th. And then go back. So that's the 7th fret over here with your ring finger. Go up to the 9th. And then go back to the 7th. And then go to the 5th. And do that twice. And then go down to the 3rd fret with your index finger. And that's all on the 5th string. And then you can go back to the lyrics. So, to the chords. But I'm just going to play that again really slowly. Okay, so I'm just gonna put that in context with the first bit as well. It should all sound like this. And that's that little riff, and it's great, and then you go back to the chords. So once you kind of get the chords and that bit really well worked out, it's a bit hard in the beginning because you stop and you have to go straight away. But again, practice makes perfect. So if you can add that, it's a really, really nice little thing to the song. It's a really nice touch and it adds a lot more depth to it as well. So that was it. That's the whole of Jack Johnson. Now, you can do it with open chords, like I said at the beginning. And it will sound very similar. It just won't have that kind of element of percussion inside it. And it basically goes like this. Just the G on the open chords, so that's the 3rd finger over here on the 3rd fret. And then you have your middle finger on the 2nd fret of the 5th string. And then you're going to put your little finger down over here on the 3rd fret of the 1st string. And that's your basic G chord. And then you're basically going to have to go into the C chord after that, so that's the 3rd finger over here on the 3rd fret of the 5th string. And then you're going to take your middle finger, you're going to put it on the 2nd fret of the 4th string. And your index, as always, well not always, but on this one, your index is just going to go on the 1st fret of the 2nd string. So that chord. And then you're going to go up to the D chord, which is basically your index on the 2nd fret of the 3rd string, and then your ring finger on the 3rd fret of the 2nd string, and your middle finger on the 2nd fret of the 1st string. That's going to sound like this. And that's the chords you're going to need to know for the open chord section, basically. Okay, so now that you know those open chords, we're just going to basically do the rhythm that kind of suits it the best when you're playing open chord anyway. And that's our good old friend, the down, down, up, up, down rhythm. And on the G chord, so the 1st chord, you're basically going to do that rhythm twice. So down, down, up, down, 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 up, up, down. And then you're going to go to the C by just basically moving these two down here and adding your little index on this fret. Down, down, up, up, down. And then all the way down here. And it's funny because you can actually take those fingers and just put them all the way down here. And it actually bring your index just in here and it goes pretty smooth actually. Yeah. Like this. And just one more. Down, down, up, up, down. So, yeah, we're going to do that again, just really slowly. G, C, D. So. That's it. Obviously, it goes a lot faster. But in the beginning, it's good to really practice the time signature and the changes and stuff. And so it's really good to go slowly in the beginning. And once you're more kind of used to those chords and changing those chords, then you can start going a bit faster. And once you do that, again, you can do the whole song, and you can even add this little riff, and it'll sound great. So practice hard, have a good time learning this one. It's a really nice song, and once you got those just chord patterns and time signatures down, you can really kind of play the whole song and sing as hard as you want. So good luck learning it, and come around again for another video lesson by guitarlessonlounge.com. I've been Tebow. It's been a pleasure.